And now we have this empty loop, air loop. It doesn't have any components. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create another system here. I will just flow with the waves. I'm going to add some new stuff. We'll go through my library and see if I can create some interesting HVAC loop for you. Okay. So from library, the first thing that I'm going to bring is one outdoor air controller, outdoor air system. So outdoor air system is here. You can see it here. Air loop HVAC outdoor air system. Drag it and drop it on this node, the existing node. You can rename it now. You can rename it later. First of all, I want to click on this dotted line and I'm going to rename it properly. I don't like this name, so I'm going to rename it like VAV, water-based system. Let's say it's a very long name, but yeah, let's just give it something unique, okay? Because this is going to be my primary system, so I'm not going to size it for 100% outdoor air in heating and cooling. If it's a DOA air system, dedicated outdoor air system, then yes, you need to size it for 100% outdoor air in heating as well as in cooling. Okay, so for now, rest of the values seem fine. This you can see here, even the type of load to size on is sensible. If it's dedicated outdoor air system, then you need to select ventilation requirement. Okay, so next thing what I can bring is I can bring one fan. Let me just bring a fan here. Maybe a variable fan, variable speed fan, drag it and drop it on this node here. And what if you have one variable fan even at demand side? Let's just drop it here. You can see it's not allowed here. So a lot of times people think that you can drop